Our journey begins as all great journeys do, on Wikipedia. While perusing the pages one day, I stumbled across a page that piqued my interest, Edomoji, meaning Edo script characters. Different Edomoji styles were used during the Edo period for advertising, promoting sumo events, and most interesting to me, seals. You see, I love seals. Not the seals that you find in the ocean, but I have nothing against them, but seals they use in China, Korea, and Japan. I love looking at seals from history like the imperial seals of China, or even the modern seals that they use in parts of Asia today. I even have my own seal, which I got when I went to Shanghai. So, when I saw this tiny section on Wikipedia talking about kakuji, literally block characters, I really wanted to use this style of characters in my own projects. After a quick Google search, I found a font that had mapped certain kakuji characters to the letters on your keyboard, A to Z, and some of these glyphs weren't designed very well. This isn't really what I wanted. I wanted a font that gave me the kakuji-styled character when I typed it out. In other words, when I type out Edomoji in Japanese, I get the kakuji for Edomoji. But after more poking around, I realized that there was nothing like that at all. To me, this felt tragic. This is a part of history that should be available to people, and it just looks so cool. So I decided that I would take it upon myself to design a proper kakuji font. I had no idea where to start. I had worked with Unicode and Chinese characters for years, but I had never tried to actually create a font before. So I started at the very beginning. Well, not that far in the beginning. Rather, I looked for some open source font designing software, and the prime candidate that I decided to play around with was called FontForge. FontForge was initially published in 2001, originally created by George Williams, and while it's not the industry's main software for font design, it would more than suffice for my needs. Unfortunately, this is also where I realized that I had no clue on how to design a font. I played around with a glyph editor and read some documentation and figured out what I needed to do to make a new glyph. Since kakuji is literally block characters, all I had to do was use straight lines to outline the characters. Unfortunately, and this is probably due to my lack of knowledge, I couldn't figure out how to get the lines super straight. And even if I wasn't inept at drawing with my mouse, this project would still take me a year and a half to do by hand. But then I saw this glimmer of hope. This light breaking through the clouds. Execute script. I just finished writing my first useful Python program a few weeks earlier. A calendar that shows the time of day and gives you which of the 24 Chinese seasons it is. So I started playing around with the execute script feature in FontForge. I again read the documentation of scripting FontForge, a nearly decade-old document at this point, but I figured out the basics of using Python to create new glyphs, and drawing shapes and saving it to the desired format. Now, the idea was I could use Photoshop to create these kakuji designs and use this PNG, which had my character laid out in black. Using the FontForge Python tools, I created a new glyph based on the file name and break it into a graph with the relative size being the same as in the PNG. I then analyze each pixel. If it's transparent, I skip it. If it isn't, I draw a square. Once I finish iterating through each pixel in the image, I'm left with a glyph with a bunch of polygons in it, and thanks to FontForge's amazing scripting tools, I'm able to remove any overlap and merge it all into one body. Using this script, I am able to take a whole folder of PNG images and turn them all into glyphs for my font at the same time. I can then export this file to a TrueType font file, and install that on my computer. All I had to do now was create all the characters using Photoshop. Online, I found that there were about 200 characters of kakuji that people had documented from this script. So I took the time to design each character, one after the other, and once I had these original 200, I sent them through the system. And the results look amazing. Now I'm able to simply type any of these 200 characters, and there it is in all its glory. I sat back, satisfied that I had done what I wanted to do. And then I came back. I wanted to do more. I wanted to expand the font to include more characters than I had seen before. So I started naturally with family names. Kakuji were of course supposed to be characters that you would use for a seal. so I went and found a list of the most common Japanese last names. And while most of them had been covered by the original 200 I had already designed, I went into Photoshop and created the rest of what hadn't been touched yet. Then I added a few more frills, the Chinese zodiac, a few miscellaneous words, my own Chinese name, just a few things to make it more unique and really put my own name on it. Then I started the laborious process of designing the list of names from the ancient 100 Family Surnames book, written in China during the Song Dynasty. Now, the full book actually contains over 400 last names, but I only did the first 100. Again, it took a few days to design all these characters in Photoshop, but in the end, it was well worth it. Just a few seconds in the machine, and they came out hot off the press, and it looked just like I wanted it to. I now had a beautiful font which carried on the history from whence it came. It was at this point where I realized that there were actually two different ways to use Kokuji. One of these was the way I had been using so far, the one I'd originally seen on Wikipedia, with the character itself being the colored section. But looking at what I've determined is the original modern source material, the quote, large Itomoji dictionary, is that the characters are outlined in ink, and the character itself is transparent. For a minute, I was conflicted whether I needed to redo the style of the whole font, and then I realized,
¿por qué no los dos?
I could have two different font styles, one which I now call New Kokuji, since I've expanded it so much beyond the original character set, and the other I will call New Kokuji Bold, which will follow the same style found in the Itomoji dictionary with the characters being outlined. And with my Python script, all I had to do was the reverse of what I had done before. Instead of placing the blocks in the non-transparent parts, I'd place them on the transparent parts, and then I'd skip the parts that weren't transparent, creating the exact outline of the characters. Once again, I'd send everything through the program, and 2 minutes later, there it was, another style of Kokuji. Now, there's only one last obstacle to getting my font to the world, that being getting my font to the world. I do have my own website, not in that Tokyo, but I felt that leaving such a masterpiece in a far-flung, never-visited corner of the internet would be an injustice to it. So I went straight to the top, fonts.com, or rather, the greater parent company, Monotype. I applied to become a foundry, yes, that's what they call a company that designs fonts, and took upon me the name Itomoji Type. It took a little while to be approved, but that's alright because I actually had to expand my font even more. You see, there's a recommended character set, which was, well, recommended to have in your font if you want to get it approved. Now, this isn't always necessary for stylistic fonts, and New Kokuji is by no means an everyday replacement for the layman's Chinese or Japanese, but I wanted to give it the best chance of being accepted by the font community. Now, I could have been lazy and slapped in some regular-looking letters, but I had come this far and I wanted to keep it consistent. This meant even more hours spent designing appropriate designs for A, B, C, and Z. And I decided to keep lowercase and uppercase the same. I won't let any lowercase inventing Greeks tell me how to design my font. But not only did I need a G, an H, and even an I, but I also needed a period, a semicolon, a left and a right facing bracket, and everything in between. After another day and a half of trying to get the designs looking all right, I came up with this set of Western characters. By no means is this very pretty. I'm not a designer, so those original designs are probably the worst looking parts of the font. But luckily, that's not the point of the font. Either way, I finished these designs and now I could officially submit my font. And here it is, in all its glory. Now, I'm not closing the book on this yet. I'm still on the lookout for new characters in the records that I haven't added to the font yet, and if I find any, I'll add them. To that end, I've ordered a copy of the Itomoji Dictionary from Japan, and hopefully I'll either confirm that this is the extent of the script as we know it, or I'll add everything that the internet hasn't documented yet. But for now, New Kokuji font is available, and it's beautiful. Again, I'm not a designer. I'm a programmer who also owns Photoshop. Without Font Forge's scripting tools, I would not have been able to design this font at all. I'm lucky to live in a world where 20-year-old software can be used in tandem with a 30-year-old programming language to resurrect a 200-year-old style of 5,000-year-old characters. If you're interested in checking out the Python code I wrote for yourself, send me an email at inkboxsoftware@notin.tokyo. Until next time, thanks for watching.